This is the hour of deliverance coming to you from Pastor Amos Dada. May your life be transformed by this experience.
Just never succeeds. They must quit. They must find faults. His mates are doing it. All your people are doing it. Even those who are earning less than you, they are facing their time. Those who are earning higher than you, they are facing. You have one reason. Oh, my business. Oh, my rent. Oh, my this one. Let me tell you what you have. It is the spirit of what?
Yeah.
This morning, deal with it. Are you listening to me? Because you are pursuing, you are inviting a devourer. Because God says, if you are faithful in this, I will ensure you don't have what? Devourer. I will manage the resources. I will take care of your expenses. Can God do it?
Yes.
Are you so good? I said, can God take care of your expenses?
Sir.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Before you leave this church this morning, God will announce you.
Amen.
God will provide for you.
Amen.
He makes us to understand as we are learning this Sunday school, is the owner. Read that there for me. Chapter 2, verse 7 and 8. All monies, all silver, all gold. Who is winning?
The Lord to you.
Yes, quickly. Haggai chapter 2. 8 and 9. Some people are wasting my time.
The silver is mine.
The gold is mine. Says Pastor Dada.
No.
Says Jimmy Harper.
No.
Oh, Obama.
No.
The silver is mine. The gold is mine. Says.
Lord.
Says.
Lord.
Says.
Lord.
Why are you denying God what he has? It is the spirit of Demas. You will not walk in it. The spirit of Demas is the spirit of a loser. The spirit of devil is the spirit that starts well and ends nowhere. You will not end nowhere.
Yeah.
It is the spirit of fault finding. They find fault. We don't have beat about it, but have found fault with his what? With his mentor. This one is too pushful. Every day, today, missionary this. Today, missionary that. Today, missionary. The God was building him up. Today, we will be reading what? Five synoptic what? Gospels. Who will have been reading the gospel according to what? Demas. But because he was finding fault. Don't find fault with Pastor Dada. Amen.
Amen.
Don't find fault with these pastors because they love you. They are spending all their time praying, encouraging you. Amen.
Amen.
Don't quit church because of their message. Because their message is to help you. Don't quit church. Stay with what God wants to do in your life. Watch God humble yourself. Humble himself in your life. Because he has given you one person. You are running away. No! They must run away and run to perdition. Run to destruction. Run to what? Oblivion. Run to nowhere. You will not go nowhere.
Amen.
In the name of Lord Jesus.
Amen.
It is the spirit that wastes future. You will not waste your future.
Amen.
Oh, somebody say amen.
Amen.
You will not waste my future. Say it again. I will not waste my future.
I will not waste my
future. Say it again. I will not waste my future. It's a party spirit. It's a worldly spirit. It is the spirit of easy virtue. Easy virtue. Easy virtue. The only thing I have is to sell my body. No, that's not the only thing. You have brain. Someone say, I have brain.
I have brain.
It's good that God made you handsome, made you beautiful, but he gave you the best. Your best asset in life is your brain.
Yes,
somebody say amen.
Amen.
Someone say amen.
Amen.
Someone say amen.
Amen.
Someone say amen.
Amen.
I don't know where I was sharing this, whether I'm going to the church or during the week. You know, there are some people who are what? Who are carrying loads. Big loads, and they are giving them what? $10 per hour. And there are people who are what? Sitting in AC, and they pay them what? $150 per what? How much do you think the doctors are earning? Amen.
Amen.
Amen. When you are carrying load, you now come to him now and say, can I see? Okay, see that here now. You don't buy something. For that one that he loads, is having millions. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
I say somebody say amen.
Amen.
Because it's using what?
Amen.
It's using what?
Brain.
Say, oh Lord.
Oh Lord.
Help me
Help me to use my brain.
Help me to affect this generation with my brain. There's nothing wrong with your brain. You need brain, you need energy to carry on something that's been deposited in your life. Use it well. Devil uses his own negatively. He sat down. He found reasons to do what? To quit. And he quit it. The word to believe you. It is the spirit of failure that will not fail.
Amen.
So someone said that will not fail.
Amen.
This is why he left the gospel. Number one, he loved the world. He loved what?
Loved the world.
He loved what?
What?
1 John 2, verse 15 to 16. Love not the world, neither the thing that is in the world. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him. For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, the pride of life, is not in the Father, but is what? Of the Lord. He had a friend. He referred. You see, I want you to know something. Praise the Lord. We are human beings. We are what?
Human beings.
We are what?
Human beings.
We all love the world. Hello? Hello?
Hi, sir.
Anybody who doesn't love the world here? Don't deceive yourself. We all love the world. Amen?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I love getting out with my wife. Glory be to God. I love going on vacation. You know, in the environment where they call American what? American dream is about loving the world. You want to, if you have this house, you feel, this house is not. The moment you have a bigger money, you want to buy what? A bigger house. The moment you have the, even though you have been riding your what? Honda, you have been enjoying it, the economy is super. But the moment you have money, say, there is also Lexus. Amen. And you go from that money, you are looking for bedroom. We all have that appetite for it. Someone say amen. And God will prosper. But loving the world is not about desiring those things. It's about desiring those things at what? The expense of your soul. The expense of your soul. When you now, instead of doing things that will help you with the money God has given you, with the body God has given you, with the knowledge God has given you, and you are now doing what? Loving the world. You know, some people, God gave them beautiful voices. Hello?
Yes.
Hello?
Hi.
Hello?
Hi.
Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
Beautiful what? Voices that he wants them to write songs, shouts. You know, I was reading a book only this week about the woman that wrote what? You see, shout, what's this one from his song? Shout hallelujah, amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord. That became a celebrity or celebrated song. He wasn't a songwriter, he wasn't in the choir. They had somebody who arranged song, who they prayed everything, he has taught them, and the last minute this man just went away. This man just went away. And somebody said, but darling is here. Darling just wrote a song. She was the secretary to the pastor. Not a songwriter. But she was just composing song where she was. And they brought that song, and that song now became what? Even his song from Australia became known in the world because a secretary wrote the song. There is something inside of you that will come out.
Amen.
In the name of Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Using your talent for the gospel, not to be against the gospel. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We love the world, but we don't want to love the world at the expense of our lives. Number two, amen. To love the world is to prefer sins to a life of holiness. To love the world is to not to know the boundaries. To love the world is not to go overboard. To love the world is to pitch your tent with mockers. How do we get blessed and prosperous? The Bible says, Psalm 1 to 3, it says, What's Psalm 1 now? Blessed is the man that walketh not the world in the counsels of the ungodly, nor sit with sinners, nor stand with what? With mockers. But his delight is what? Is in the law of the Lord, but he need not see what? Meditate day and night. And in this, what happens to him? He will be like a tree by the riverside. His leaves shall not wither. Whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. You will prosper.
Amen.
Number two, that he did was what? He was idle. He was what? He was what? He was what? Say it louder.
Idle.
Tell your neighbor, don't be idle.
Don't be idle.
Tell yourself, it was daily like that. Don't be idle. Idlers never go up, they go down. Proverbs 6:6. Thou sluggard, go to what? Go to the ants and what? He said they don't have pastors, they don't have preachers, they don't have leaders, but they know when it is winter, they can't come out. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You can wear coats now, ooh, ooh, but you must still go to work, isn't it?
Yeah.
Ants knew that he cannot go to work. He can't, there is no clothes. He will die. So during summer, what does it do? He makes all the food and then they build a hill and they stay there. And when winter is out, they smell it. And then they come out again and begin to gather food. Ants are not idle. Why will you be idle? You will no more be idle.
Amen.
The spirit of idleness will not be your portion.
Amen.
I said the spirit of idleness will not be your portion.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
He was not involved. He was not committed. Look at his fellow brothers. As I said, what they did. How do you know you are idle? Write this down. Take an image of how you live your days. We all have 24 hours. How many hours do you sleep? Everybody has 24 hours. Somebody say 24 hours.
24 hours.
What makes the difference between us is what? 8 hours. Did you hear me? 8 what?
Hours.
Everybody's allocated 8 hours to do what? To sleep. 8 hours to do what? To work. Then you have what? 8 hours left. What you do with your extra 8 hours determines whether you become president or become what? Chauffeur driver to what? To president. You didn't hear me? I said you didn't hear me. I said you didn't hear me. It's not what about what is your head, it's what you do with that work. If you find out that that's the time you are what? Playing check again. That's the time you carry phone. Hey! Oh boy, you not dead so? Oh yeah, wait for me now. Hang on, 1 minute. You finish that one. Oh, hang on. Oh, where is everybody? Because they are wasting your life. They are what?
Wasting my life.
They are what? They are wasting your life. There are times you must shut up your phone. Shut up everything. Whether it is in there. So who will be paying? Where's your phone? Give me one phone. Quickly. Thank you. And then this moment, you are wasting your time. Does he not know he can give message? Is there no provision to give message? Oh, okay. All right. When I finish, you don't need to. You are talking to God Almighty. Hallelujah. Take inventory. Oh, you see, I don't always want to balance time here. This is my constraint. When my wife gave me report, they closed the service 1 o'clock. The moment I asked her, how was the service? The first thing, they closed the service. I said, what does that mean? Shout hallelujah!
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 Shout hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
When God gives us stuff, we have to visit her. This will help your life. Would you like to close now?
No.
You want me to close?
No.
Shout hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Amen. You will not go beyond 130. I promise you that. Amen. Amen. Don't be a mediocre, be a champion. Be what?
Be a champion.
No, the way that you are not, you will look at yourself, am I pursuing to be a champion? Am I pursuing to be a master in my region? Am I pursuing? Some people are in church now. Amen?
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
They dance, they flummox, and you wonder what is wrong. They train themselves. What are you training yourself to be? What am I training myself to be? What do you do with the word of God you hear every Sunday? What do you do with the exhortation, the messages? He was idle. I imagine somebody with Paul and still being idle. Somebody with Paul, everybody, even Paul died so many years ago, Everybody cannot but be blessed by the life of Paul. And yet this man found fault and went away. He must have said that he's driving me too hard. I don't like people driving me too hard. They are driving you for your good.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
They are driving you for your good. Oh, pastor said we should come early to church. It is for your good. Pastor said we should pray. It is for your good. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I said, how do you know whether you are idle? How many hours do you spend in prayer? How many hours do you spend in meditating on the word of God? How many hours do you spend in your business? Hallelujah. I said hallelujah.
Amen.
I said hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
For people, when they don't have anything to do, they think. They begin to think how to make their life better. How to make their marriage better. May God make you a thinker.
Amen.
Hallelujah. He said, as a man thinketh, so is he. Don't spend your time in idleness. And God will help you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I say hallelujah.
Amen.
So compare how many hours you spend to watch movies and what type of movies you watch. Amen.
Amen.
And I was told in an hotel that hosted a Christian group over a weekend. And the time they left, they found out that even secular group did not watch extreme movies as the Christian group. That is immediate. Number three, he departed. Someone say he departed.
Departed.
Someone say he departed.
He departed.
As the final straw. He will not be a greater. And I said again, there's nothing wrong about departing. Hello?
Hi.
There's nothing wrong about departing. It is where you are departing from. Where you are departing. Did you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Did you hear me?
Yes, sir.
We all have to depart. I was one time pastoring in Toronto, Nigeria, amen?
Yeah.
Then I departed to this place, amen?
Yeah.
Whole region. Because God said, I should what? Depart. That is a departing. Departing for what? Put Canada on the what? On the spiritual map of the world. Is it us? No. God's us? Yes. Achievable? Yes. How? Looking unto him, the author and finisher of my what? Of my faith. Can I read the law? No. Do I need you? Yes. Do you need me? Yes. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
In Genesis chapter 12, he said, Abraham, leave your kids and came and go to the land I'm going to show you. Amen. And there, whoever blesses you is blessed. You are better blessed, Pastor.
Amen.
Hello?
Hi.
Oh, you are blessed me now. Say, Lord, I'm blessed, Pastor.
I'm blessed, Pastor.
You are blessed.
Amen.
You have a precious blessing.
Amen.
The Lord bless you.
Amen.
Lord, make his face to shine upon you. As you have blessed me today, according to the word of God, may you be blessed.
Amen.
I won't tell you to do the other one. Because if you do the other one, I'm going to bring back. Someone say amen.
Amen.
Don't try to cause Pastor that, because God will cause you.
God,
he said to Abraham, if they bless you, they are blessed. If they curse you, they are cursed. And the Bible says, verse 4, Genesis chapter 2, and Abraham departed. Some people say, Abraham
departed
to obey God. In Genesis chapter 22, the Bible says, and God tempted Abraham and said, your only son, do what? Go and sacrifice it to me. And the Bible said, verse 2, and Abraham departed. When you depart to obey God, you will go higher.
Amen.
I say, anytime you depart in obedience to the word of God, you are going higher.
Amen.
You are going higher.
Amen.
You are going higher.
Amen.
I said, you are going higher.
Amen.
You are going higher.
Amen.
You are going higher.
Amen.
From today, you will go higher.
Amen.
I said, you will go higher.
Amen.
I said, you will go higher.
Amen.
I said, you will go higher.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I said, why did he depart? Maybe he was looking for psychic power to do the gospel. You know, this time around, we don't even know it's true now. Anyway. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I watched a video of a woman who was telling about her pastor being what? Fake. This man said his passion was what? Faith. He showed himself, you know, where he will be the one. Yeah, any woman. He will face being what? Being mad. He will dress her up as what? As a mad person. Take a picture. Then they will come to their crusade and service. And as they are praying, hey, I'll be what?
Healed.
In sure herself is there. Sure is there. Go to YouTube, you will see it. I'm not going to mention it. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
In sure herself, somewhere where is what? It's lame. Cannot walk. And then they will bring her to what? To the crusade ground. And we do what? She will get to hey. Now I read to yesterday, the same pastor that was doing that was saying in another crusade that there are false prophets. We have come to a level where we don't even know whether we are false prophets ourselves or not. It's now saying that there are prophets who today they go to Port Harcourt. For those who come from Nigeria, they said there is a woman there they go to who will give them what? Power. And then they'll be able to tell you that there's somebody here, his name is what? Shego Ogubayo. They will tell you your what? Your bank account. They will tell you what is exact. And it's true. They will tell them what is in their what? Their bank account. They will tell them their phone number. They will tell them their yes! Maybe whoever did his own evil for her name did not go to that level. He's now abusing those men, but himself is as what? As washed. What am I saying? Many of you are running, you are having the spirit of demons because somebody is telling you your phone number. Don't you know your phone number? Why are you looking at me like? Does anybody need to tell you your phone number?
No.
You see, some of us are gullible. Somebody is telling you your house address. Is it? Don't you know your house address? That somebody is now telling you your phone address, and then you leave church, and then begin to empty your what? Your pocket for him because he told you your house address. It's the spirit of demons. May the Lord deal with them.
Yeah.
In the name of Lord Jesus Christ. Enough is enough. We are building you up on the solid foundation. We are telling you, don't be a demons. Stop wandering about looking for vision when there's no vision. People go and wash their face and do all kinds of things. There is genuine prophecy in the church of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I said hallelujah.
Amen.
God by the word of God. And God will prosper you.
Amen.
I said my God will prosper you.
Amen.
I said my God will prosper you.
Amen.
Don't know what he did. Maybe some brethren provoking. And that's what happened. Oh, when you are dancing, and your mind screen was on my leg, that's why you are going out of the church. No! No! That's not the solution. That's not the solution. It is the spirit of demons. That will not be your portion.
Amen.
Maybe he had issues with his pastor. The way pastor that I shouts, I don't like it. You are better like it. Amen?
Amen?
Amen. Amen. It is to help you understand. There are some people, they are what? They are mine. Oh Lord, thank you for this service. Thank you, Lord. Blessed be your name. That's their style. That's not my style. But that doesn't mean I'm wrong. Hello?
Hi, sir.
Hello?
Hi, sir.
Hello?
Hi.
Hello?
Hi.
Hello?
Hi.
That doesn't mean those who are quiet are wrong. Amen.
Amen.
It means this is where God wants to prosper you. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I said shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I said shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Tell your neighbor, don't find issues with me.
Don't
quit church because of me. I have good intentions.
Hallelujah.
I'm here to help you.
Hallelujah.
I'm here to help your life.
Hallelujah.
I'm a blessing to you.
Hallelujah.
Don't quit ministry.
Don't quit
because of me. Hallelujah! Some people because of their neighbor. You know there are some races. Once they see some races coming, they sell their car. They sell their house, they are gone. No, you don't have to. You don't have to. We are all made in the image of God.
Amen.
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 I see the right signal now coming. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Maybe you fell sick. If you are sick, God will heal you.
Amen.
I say, we heal you.
Amen.
Maybe you thought this ministry should be bigger than what it is. Don't quit ministry because your ministry is not growing. Wait on the Lord. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew his strength. Don't quit your life. Quit against yourself because your friend is doing well. Oh, we are together. We are together. And now his weak is what? Is riding what car? Bentley. And here we now, struggling with what? A Passat. What sort of life is this one? You have commit suicide. When you commit suicide, will you ever buy Bentley? Do you know what God has in a future for you? No, don't quit. My God knows tomorrow. My God knows that way. Rise up on your feet. You are within the GTA. Our church is Christ Apostolic Church, Bethel, Toronto. We are located at 94 Kenham Drive, Suite 22. Our major intersection is Western Road and Finch Avenue. The phone numbers are written on the screen. Call us. We have a church bus that can carry you from anywhere to be part of what we are doing.
This message is brought to you by friends and partners of this ministry. Would like to invite you to be a partner, and as you do, the Lord will prosper the work of your hands. Please call the number on the screen, 416-616-2425 or 647-430-8936. You can also visit our website at www.cacbethel.com. God bless you.